The heartbeat of competition, the drama of the moment. This is NASCAR on Mick Blam Racing.
The races at Talladega proved to be surprising and fun, but now it's time to get tougher, and there is no place that gives us a tougher time than Dover. Good afternoon, race fans. I'm Micah McBlam, your commentator and driver of the number 22 LTI Printing Ford for Roger Penske Racing, and we're moments away from a gladiator-style battle not only between the drivers, but the drivers versus the monster that looms beneath the tire tracks on this very concrete. A monster known for grabbing and tearing up race cars as well as breaking spirits. This is Bristol on steroids, but most people just call it the Monster Mile. McBlam Racing welcomes you to the NASCAR Xfinity Series running of the One Main Financial here at the Dover International Speedway. If you enjoyed this content, be sure to subscribe and click the notification bell so you don't miss out on weekly NASCAR racing content during the real-life NASCAR season. The threat to win always starts on the pole, and this week's threat goes by the name of Michael Annette. The NASCAR Heat 4 Pole Award goes to the number one pilot Flying Jade of that Dirty Mo posse. It's Junior Motorsports' first season pole, but this team hasn't found victory lane as of yet this season. Perhaps it is a feat they can accomplish here on the concrete. We're in a rhyming mood here this afternoon at Dover as the field is set for NASCAR Xfinity Series racing here at the Monster Mile. Michael Annette starting on pole, looking to capitalize on the strong season he's had so far, finally trying to find himself in victory lane as Elliott Sadler starts on the outside in P last after failing tech inspection. We're starting P37. It's a 1-2 front row leading the future stars to the line. Green flag is in the air. Let's breathe the noise here on the concrete. First lap of the race is complete. Michael Annette out to a very, very early lead. We know that car can lead early. Ooh, bump from behind from the 38 of Josh Balicki. He looks to our inside, three wide off turn number two. United of Morgan Shepherd gave us plenty of room there. I was kind of happy about that. I was worried about doinking off of him because this is a place where the AI don't run lines that necessarily make sense. They'll run up top, but the problem is they won't finish up top. And it can lead to a lot of issues where you can just kind of doink off of them because they don't go all the way to the wall. But this is also a place where if you leave them an inch on the bottom, they will gain about 5 or 6 miles per hour. We're trying to get around the 13 of John Jackson. Ooh, caught that apron a little bit there, but that's one of those issues we're going to be battling quite a bit during this particular race. Get to the inside of Vinny Miller. I'm going to try to be as patient as possible here. One of the things they're definitely going to be battling during this race is where the AI are particularly going to run, as we almost got up into Tommy Joe Martin's that time. Coming off turn number two. This is one of those places where the AI, they're predictable, but not predictable. You don't know when they're going to get that smoking hot run. There you go with Zane Smith. Zane Smith did not exit at the top, and he came off the top, and that caused me to have to lift and just kind of let him go there. But because of that, we can't really carry the momentum that we need to be carrying off the corner for that very reason. If someone's to our outside, it kind of makes it even more difficult than it really should be to try to pass them. We worked our way into 23rd place. Now I'm going to start to work on Josh Williams here. I'm just going to try to stay as dedicated to the bottom as I can. Josh Williams runs up top. And this isn't a place where you can really put down hot laps. Unless you're in the lead, you're not really going to be putting down some hot laps here. If you're battling through traffic, good luck trying to get, you know, one of the fastest laps of the race or anything like that, because it's just so much congestion that you have to really work through. Granted, the dynamic racing lines do tend to help out with that quite a bit. So we're coming up on Noah Gragson. Lifted a little bit just to give him a little bit extra room coming off the corner there. Didn't want to get into the back of him. Noah Gragson had been struggling this weekend. As said earlier on in the race from the race stories, he's going to be having some trouble getting around this racetrack. We got a little bit tight. Center of the corner there. He's going to fight back on the outside. One lap to go in the stage. Made slight contact, but no harm, no foul. Michael Annett wins stage number one here at Dover. And it looks like we're going to finish this stage in P20. Pretty solid run so far. Pretty solid run. Like I said, just trying to be patient around this racetrack right now. But let's check out the results for the stage. We have Michael Annett finishing P1, then Christopher Bell, Tyler Reddick, Cole Custer, Jeffrey Earnhardt will round out the top five. Allgaier, Michael's teammate, John Hunter Nemechek, Chastain Haley, and Brandon Jones will round out the top 10 for the stage. We're going to go ahead and bring it down pit road. Tire management is definitely going to be a thing here. Tire management is definitely going to be a thing. We're a bit snug, but I think I want it that way just to make sure we can last in the long runs. And then maybe if we have something towards the end, we'll loosen it up. But here we go. Green flag is back in the air. Pilot Flying J is going to lead them down into turn number one as we are barely on the throttle. Trying not to run over Stephen Light there. Got both of the Flexio Mobiles in front of us. Into the inside of BJ McLeod. Brandon Brown. Gonna work our way around him, possibly. Tap the apron a little bit there, but we do manage to clear him up into P17. Now inside of Joey Gase. Gase is gonna try to look three wide. He looked and thought about it. But he backs out of that, wisely backs out of that. A little bit too early in the race for that. We got the 98, Chase Briscoe, who was on our outside, but kind of fell back there. How about Mike Harmon up here in the top 15? Mike Harmon has not had a good run since Texas, I believe. Yeah. Texas pole winner Mike Harmon. Ooh, don't lose it, Mike. Don't lose it. Easy there, buddy. Easy. We're getting to the inside of Mike Harmon right now. Side drafting. Down the front stretch as we get to the inside of Ryan Sieg. I came up on him a little bit faster than I thought I was going to. And there's that thing where I said, like, if you leave a little bit of a lane open, they just kind of rip it around the bottom. One of the things that I really want them to fix in future games, because this is not just it's more pronounced in the heat games. It's way more pronounced in the heat games, but this is not a thing that, oh, we're going three wide in the middle. I don't know about this. Oh, Chase Briscoe gets up into us. We get up into Mike Harmon. Everybody keeps it going straight. Briscoe looks like he caught the apron there, came up into us. He gives us another tap. Ryan Sieg trying to fight back on the outside. He said this is a little bit too rich for his blood, backs right on out of it. We're going to try to battle side by side with the 98. I don't know if we're going to have anything for him. Actually, we do, but we catch the wall. Just kissed the wall just a little bit there. Ooh, Mike Harmon got a little bit loose going into one that time. Meanwhile, Michael Ondesh just kind of walking away with it. He's like, all right, I'm going to let all y'all just kind of battle it out. Oh, man, caught the wall again. Oh, man. A bit of a front tire issue here. Did we put a bad set of tires on this car or something? The front end is not gripping up the way it was in stage number one. So, but then again, we also weren't going as fast as we are now. We're actually running much faster laps than we were in stage number one, mainly because we're around faster cars. But how about Mike Harmon? Mike Harmon's worked his way up into P12. Never thought I'd have to be chasing down the Harmonator, but hey, I'm not even mad at it. He's chasing down the number 11 car right now. Number 11's running P11. Oh no! Justin Haley, problems for the 11 as we get into him! You couldn't hold the brake, could you, Justin? You just couldn't hold the brake. Golly. Well, that's some damage we're going to have to fix now. Michael Annette wins the stage, followed by Tyler Reddick, who started outside pole. Christopher Bell falls back to third. Ross Chastain, Jeffrey Earnhardt still holding solid in the top five. Brandon Jones, Cole Custer, Justin Allgaier, Gray Galding, and Ray Black Jr. works his way up into the top 10 to end stage number two. I'm curious as to where this is going to put us. After repairing this damage, 13, that we actually gained a spot. Okay, so I guess we weren't the only ones that had some damage to fix after that wreck. So, hey, I'll take it. Michael Annette leads him to the line. Green flag is in the air for stage number three. Big jump on the start there. Mike Harmon gave us all the room to get down to the bottom. We worked our way into the top 10 inside of Greg Galding, perhaps? Not quite. Ooh. He thought about trying to shut that door. Here comes the Harmonator. Mike trying to work his way back up into the top 10 as we're battling side by side with the 08 of Greg Galding. We go hard into turn number one. And clear him. Meanwhile, Michael Ondesh again walking away with it. And there's that massive run that they get on the inside. But it looks like the 74 couldn't maintain the momentum there. We're now trying to hunt down Ross Chastain. Up in the P8. This is kind of where I expect to be running here at Dover. We're not particularly good here. You can drive Dover pretty hard. I will say that. You can drive Dover pretty hard. You can go into the corners pretty hard, get back to the gas really quick. But that's, again, that's kind of like in a hot lap type of situation where you have room to do that. You see, like, I could have done it, but I would have been sliding right up into Ross Chastain. That's not what I want to do. But Chastain's making a big move to the inside of Cole Custer. Cole Custer currently sitting second in points. 59 points back as of this race, I believe, looking to gain some momentum in the points battle. Woo! Got really loose off turn number two that time. We gather it back up. Here comes Allgaier. I got nothing for the number seven. He's going to go right on by me. Going to go right on by Cole Custer, probably. Custer trying to hold tight to his door right now. I laid off a little bit just in case those guys got into each other, which they typically don't. But like I said, I'm trying to be as patient as possible here. We fall back to P9. That 07. That 07's making some moves, man. That wasn't Custer not going to the wall. Custer was about a few inches off the wall. That was just... It's hard to try to drive around here side by side. Cole Custer's really fighting on the outside there. Oh, I was going to try to see if I could pull a slide job on him. Couldn't quite do it. Oh, boy. Still side by side off turn number four. Going down into turn number one. Oh, I got sideways into turn one that time. Got up into Cole Custer. Big battle for P8 going on the racetrack between the points leaders. Because there's no battle for the lead right now, since Michael Annette's pretty much, like I said, walking away with this. Oh, got a little bit loose, squirrely off turn number two. That allowed Cole Custer to get back around us. I'm not sure what even happened there. But it felt like the car just kind of was about to snap loose on us in the center of the turn. We're still hanging tight with Custer. Oh, big crash up ahead of us. Big crash. That was Earnhardt. Jeffrey Earnhardt was in that wreck. I'm not even sure what happened there, but man, that was a massive crash. Unfortunately, we got some damage from that, I think, because we got right up in the back of Cole Custer. I am going to loosen this car up just a tick, though. Just a tick, add some more in the right rear, just to give us a little bit more drive off the corner, but... I don't know. I guess that was not the strategy call to make, unfortunately. Looks like everyone has taken either two tires or no tires, and we've fallen back to P20. But Michael Annette is still out front. He's going to lead these band of hooligans into turn one for possibly the final time this race. The final restart of this race, I should say. Side contact with BJ McLeod. The problem is we're kind of Superman here because we're on fresh tires. Ooh, yep. Fresh tires, the front tires do not want to grip up. They do not want to grip up on fresh tires. I should have remembered that. Totally my fault as we got right into the back of Brandon Brown. Did not expect him to drive it down there. It looked like he was entering on the top, so I just kept my foot in it. We're going to have to be patient working our way through this pack here. Ooh, we might be three wide coming off the turn. Almost. Chase Briscoe carried that momentum on the outside. And Justin Allgaier takes over the race lead from his teammate. Justin Allgaier, who was making some big moves just a few laps ago. The number 7 for Junior Motorsports now takes over the race lead. Ooh, sliding it off turn number 4. Almost got up into the wall, but we kept it off of it. We're kind of getting stuck back here. We don't have many laps to go. We have to try to get up into the top 10 as quick as possible. We got around Josh Williams. Now going to work our way around Noah Gragson. We got the tires to beat these guys. That's the thing. We've got the tires to beat them. It's just like, we got to fight the racetrack, man. We got to fight the racetrack. Inside of BJ McLeod, Stephen Light goes to the top. We clear him. Just barely clear him, actually. 8 laps to go. Ryan Sieg's going to give us the high lane. We're going to use the high lane to get around Sieg and Balicki. It's squirrely off turn number 2. That's fine. Ooh. Yeah, it looks like the AI do not want, like, turning down into the corner all that much. Or either that or they just get loose. Because it looked like the 38 almost got up into me. Which is kind of what happened with Chase Briscoe in the 98. So, now we're chasing out Greg Aulding. Top 10 is within reach here. Oh boy. See if I can use that top lane and carry some momentum. We do carry that momentum. Six laps to go. Michael Annette back out front. They're battling side by side. This is the biggest battle that Michael Annette's had all race long. Still side by side. Allgaier leads that lap. Just five laps remaining. Who's going to win? It's a battle between the Junior Motorsports teammates as we're fighting and clawing to get our way back up into the top 10. Justin Haley, who had trouble earlier on this race, seems to have recovered quite nicely. It looks like Allgaier's running away with it for right now. Four to go. Oh, Justin. Justin Haley really slow on entering turn number one. But ironically enough, I think that might have helped him. I might have kickstarted his engine a little bit there. Three laps to go here at Dover. All right, where are you going, Justin? All right, Justin wants to go to the high side. Ooh, looked like he wants to go in the middle. He did want to go in the middle there, but... Oh, man. Here comes Haley fighting back on the inside. Going to try to take the top 10 away from us. Two laps to go. Oh, man, the tires just won't grip up. I'm going to have to relinquish the spot to Justin Haley. White flag is in the air for Michael Annette. Michael Annette and Justin Allgaier still fighting side by side. Who's going to make it to the line? The fight for the top 10 is on. The fight for the lead is on. Michael Annette leads it to the line. He wins here at Dover. Here comes Josh Williams making it three wide for the top 10. Off turn four, who's going to make it? We just barely made a top 10 finish here at Dover. You know what? I'll take it. I will take it. All right, ladies and gentlemen, here are the race results for the One Main Financial 200 here at the Dover International Speedway, soon to be the Dover Motor Speedway. But Michael Annette sweeps all two stages and the race win, absolute dominating for the number one car, Justin Allgaier, who I thought was actually going to win this race after seeing the drive that he had up towards the front. Didn't quite make it though, finishes in P2. Third is Christopher Bell, fourth is Tyler Reddick, rounding out the top five is Brandon Jones. We have Cole Custer, John Hunter Nemechek, Ray Black Jr., Justin Haley, and myself. We will round out the top 10 for the race. How about Mike Harmon? Mike Harmon was running in the top 10, pretty much top 15, pretty much all day. Got to give a shout out to that 74 car. And 12th place Joey Gase out of nowhere. Didn't expect that for him to have that kind of run. Anyway, here's the rest of the field where you can pick out your favorite driver. Not a good run for Noah Gragson, but it did say he was slow all weekend long. Chase Briscoe, not a good run, running towards the back there as well. Elliot Sadler only managed to get himself up to 32nd after starting in the back. And tough break of the race has got to go to Jeffrey Earnhardt, who once again was having a good run up front and tire issues took him out of the race once again. Fastest lap of the race goes to Michael Annette with a 23.26. Not a surprise there. Michael Annette leaves all the laps of the race, literally every single one. No one ever passed him. We have on the move from 37th all the way up to 10th place. Would have liked to have gotten harder, but like I said, tough break of the race goes to Jeffrey Earnhardt. Started 8th and finishes 37th. And here are the point standings after Dover. We have myself still in the points lead, 39 points ahead of the 00 of Cole Custer. Tyler Reddick is in third, 158 points back. Michael Annette closing the gap ever so slightly after his win today at Dover, but he still remains in fourth. No change as of yet from last week.
but he is about 216 points back. John Hunter Nemechek will round out the top five. We have Allgaier, Briscoe, Haley, Ray Black Jr. still up here in the top 10, and Noah Gragson in here with about 426 points back. These guys back here got some serious work to do if they're going to catch up, because it seems that myself and Cole Custer are kind of running away with it. Earnhardt's just steadily falling back after the couple of DNFs that he's had, the one at Texas and obviously the one here at Dover, which really is starting to set him back. Lane Smith not doing too terrible, but also we want to check on Mike Harmon, who is still up in the top 30 in points after running really, really well here at Dover, just unexpectedly. And we have to, of course, check on Garrett Smithley, who's comfortably in the top 25, running 24th, about 808 points back. I shouldn't say comfortably, because actually this didn't sort properly, my bad. There we go. There, we fixed that. Okay, so he is currently... This still didn't sort properly. What is going on? All right, I'll fix that. But anyway, Vinny Miller and Garrett Smithley obviously should be swapped there, but I'll have to figure out what's going on with that. But yeah, he's still sitting up in the top 25, though. He's got quite a ways before that ever comes down. So I'm not going to lie, that was probably one of the most fun races I've had at Dover. Dover's always been a tough time. If you've been on this channel for long enough, you know how Dover has been. Dover has just been an absolute nightmare for us year in, year out. No matter what game we play, Dover has always been a thing. Specifically NASCAR Thunder 2003. This game, though, like I've been noticing, like the heat games, Dover has been a lot more bearable. And I think because we started from the back, we didn't deal with the AI just kind of ripping around the bottom like they normally would. Because I think by the time that they would have been doing that, earlier on in the run, it didn't matter because I was back amongst the slower cars. So it didn't, like, that was never really a factor. Once I started moving it up through the field, you saw it a couple of times, but it was kind of typically late in the run and we didn't really have that much of an issue. However, I fought tooth and nail for that top 10 and I'm very proud of it. Very, very proud of it. So I call a top 10 at Dover. Anytime when I don't actually wreck the car completely at Dover, that's a win. That's a win in my book. But we didn't do too well last time, if I remember, in the truck series. I think we might have been able to scrounge out a top 10, but we really struggled at Dover. But got myself a good setup here from Knee Pit Gaming, so that was very, very helpful. I had to really loosen the car up quite a bit because it was just too tight in the long run, and I had to like basically drop the front weight just a little bit to get some more turn into the corner. But and then, you know, obviously loosening it up towards the end of the race there. And I know what you're probably thinking, making the four tire pit call, you know, plus the damage I had to repair as well. But like making the four tire pit stop, probably not the most ideal, but I wanted to give myself the absolute best opportunity I had to finish in the top 10. And I know how I am at Dover, and I just played it safe. Even though I almost lost it. Even though I almost lost it. We were three wide to the line coming there for the top 10, but I still made it. Our sponsorship goal is still well within reach. And we have Charlotte coming up next week. So I have not been at this racetrack in well over a year. So that should be interesting. Charlotte's always an interesting racetrack to go to just because of how interesting how weird turns 3 and 4 are, and how you have to just kind of lay off the wheel for a little bit before you actually get into the turn and then turn the race car. It's just like you're in the center of the corner before you actually start to turn. But it's always that lazy turn that always gets me. I wind up shooting up the racetrack because I turn too late, or I get down the apron because I turn too soon. But we've got that's a pretty long race. That's 50 laps. We got plenty of time to figure it out, and we're going to be starting from the back as always. So I'm not too worried. I think we can. I think a top 10 is definitely achievable there. We'll put a nice good old setup in there. See if we can get something good for a long run at the Charlotte Motor Speedway. But that is a story for another week. Until then, thank you guys so much for tuning in to the NASCAR Xfinity Series here on McLam Racing. If you enjoy these races, I do them every weekend following the NASCAR Xfinity Series IRL. So be sure to subscribe, click the notification bell so you do not miss an upload. Leave a like on the video, comment down below, hashtag way to go Mike Harmon. And once again, thank you guys so much for watching. And we'll see you possibly in a couple of weeks at Charlotte.
Well, that last race wasn't the greatest, but it happens to all of us. Keep your head up.
You know, Brandon, I used to look very dead inside whenever I raced at this track too, so I completely understand. I completely understand. But I mean, I got a top 10. That's not terrible. It's not the end of the world, Brandon, all right? Chill.